I'm working real hard getting to a point that I can send recordings after the seminars and webinars to folks. So I'm operating now under a new name for 2022. We're calling it the Academy of Entrepreneurs and Associates. And I've added the associates on here because it's just so evident how important networking is with our group. And I'm looking forward to working for all of you. I've given you a couple of places in your handouts where you can get in touch with me for various reasons when you want to, and I'll be glad to be hearing from you. Also wanted to let you know that I look forward to working with you in any way, and here's some other general contact information. I started in 1959 at 12 years old when my dad moved from Fayetteville to Dunn, North Carolina, and opened up a little Alice Chalmers tractor dealership serving farmers in our immediate vicinity. And over the 63 years, that business still goes on, but now it's an internet site, and we're working for customers all over the United States. Excuse me. Here's a copy of our home page. Over the holidays, I've completely redone our website. We'll talk about that a little bit later on today, the importance of upgrading and changing. So I look forward to it. Most nights I'm working on the internet with webinars serving these small business centers at several community colleges and you entrepreneurs all over the United States. So it's so good to be a part of your journey. I'm not a lawyer and I'm not an accountant. I'm just here offering you free advice based on my personal experiences. And the number one piece of advice I want to give to you is always get a second or third opinion. When you're making a decision about your financial security or anything where you're making a major investment. And the small business centers, wherever you're located, is the very best place or one of the very best places to get expert-free and private confidential counseling on anything related to your small business. Today we're focusing on starting an internet retail business. We're going to be talking about the basics. So some of this may be a little basic for some of you, and for others it may be the information that you need today, and it may be a little deep for you. So it's just a mixture that we need just always to understand. Anytime we can add to our knowledge and our understanding, that's going to give you better self-assurance and self-confidence. So let's go for it and see what we can do. So today we're talking about the basics. I do want you to find the chat button on your screen with the free conference call screen so that you can ask questions, request study guides. Let me know what kind of business you're into, your name, your hometown, just general stuff so that if you want me to, and or Greg to help you in the future, we'll be better off to get in touch with you. Make sure we get your email address. Mention the type of business that you're thinking about getting started. If you already have a website, then let me have your domain name, and you can put this in chat or just send me an email. That way I can check it out and maybe make some suggestions for you. Any questions you have, you're welcome to do it in chat or sending me an email. And I have lots of study guides on different subjects that I'll be mentioning, and I'm happy to email those to you as well. So we do have an Entrepreneurs Academy going on now. That's for the next six Thursday nights. We'll be talking about all aspects of getting a new business started. It's free, and you're certainly welcome to attend. So if you'd like more information on the Academy that's going on now, just drop me an email or put it in your chat, and I'll send you details related to that. I'm getting a little hoarse here. Please excuse me. And the subject today is starting an internet business. And you know what? It's kind of now or never. So let's let it. Come hold me tight, Elvis said. It is now or never, by golly. If you keep procrastinating and don't get around to starting this internet sales site, and I'm talking right directly at one of our attendees, Jimmy Packard, who's been talking about it for 2 years now, it's now or never. It's 2022, and it's time to get rocking and rolling. So I am going to do all I can to encourage you to stop procrastinating, to stop making excuses, and let's get on with this plan. There's people out there that want to give you your money out of their pocket, and I'm going to encourage you to let's go for it. So I'll be giving you lots of tips as we go along. So the first five tips are, every time that you're talking about how you're making your presentation on the internet, I suggest to you that you tell your story to make your personal presence known so that people think they're talking or know that they're communicating with someone to have a business relationship instead of just another web page. You can always go to Amazon and get all the no personality you want, but mostly small business folks are interested in creating personalities. You know why? So we can get repeat business. What are the most important parts of your web presentation? Number one is your mobile page. We'll talk a lot about that today. But look here, it's number one on my list. And number two, if you've got a web page, let's call it a landing page where people can go buy things. You can have the best website in the whole world, but if you're not selling anything from it, you're wasting your time and money. But here's what I want to say to you. We create some pages that are all about where people land and click the right spot so they can actually buy stuff from you. Whether you've got a full-fledged website up or not, it's important, and I want you to have that, which we're talking about today. But you can get your business started today by getting a Google My Business account, basically free, and start letting people on the internet know that you're here to do business. So that's a really important thing that you can do. And number five, always remember to hold yourself accountable. That is to say things that are true. Don't put any fake news out here like so common in today's world. Hold yourself accountable. Be honest. Be sincere. Be yourself and go after those positive results that you need. Now, we got to remember, and I'll mention this so many times, that no single factor, I think, today is any more important once you get into internet marketing than your ability to start using YouTube. Google bought YouTube, so they're the same company now, but if you've got videos on your web pages, they will be seen before any other web pages are seen that people have logged in for. One of you wonderful folks today, Victoria, sent me a nice presentation that she had done that we're going to talk about a lot on Thursday night with the Academy, but I responded back to Victoria, that this is really wonderful, but we need to get these messages in as many videos as we can to help our business go. Add videos or lose sales. So let's listen to that again. If you're not adding videos to your presentation, I am assuring you that you are losing sales. I know that's true because that's what's happened at my website. Every time that I add a video to one of my equipment selling landing pages, I see the sales start improving and the comments and requests for quotations start going up as soon as we put those videos on those websites. Your mobile page is all about having people call you as soon as possible. So there's several messages that I want your mobile page to have. It's call us now, it's contact us now, or it's email us now. That's what your mobile page is all about, so that when people find you, the objective here is to take them out of the shopping mode and put them into the buying mode. Because once they contact you or email you or you talk to them, it's all about telling about your story. Okay, and a few smart tips there will make a world of difference. Now, here's a copy, a picture of one of my mobile pages. Notice I've got the content information down here on the bottom, but my primary objective is to let them know they can get a quote by pressing that button, or they can hit the blue button and telephone me right now, or they could hit the green button and send me a text. That way, once we connect, once they send these messages to me, our relationship has started and the ball is in my court. I also remind them that I'm a veteran, because a lot of my customers are veterans, and if I can create common denominators with my customers, it really helps out. And more every week a customer will say to me, "Steve, I'm sending you this message because I see that you're a veteran and I want to do business with veterans." It goes a long way. Also, I want you to have your Google My Business account. This is what it looks like on the internet. You've seen these all over the place, and it's so important that you have this account. So just be ready to log in and get your Google My Business account started. Also, you, in that Google My Business account, you can engage with your customers. You can steer them to your website or to your home or to your phone number or to your email address. That's one reason it's just so important to do that. I'm going to encourage you through the course of this afternoon to get involved on Facebook. Facebook's going through a lot of changes right now, and I tried to do some work that I'm asking you to do today for my business and found it to be a little bit difficult because I wasn't used to the changes that they're making. So get involved with Facebook, get your personal page up, get your business page up, and then you'll start being able to contact more customers and spend less money. Now, I'm not advocating all the good and bad things about Facebook because there are some really things that I don't like about it, the way they are handling some of the confidentiality and letting fake news be spreaded on the internet. But I love them the way that they're helping small business people start businesses, spending very little, small amounts of money, and have a good advertising platform as well. Once you are involved on Facebook, you're going to be able to use those links, as I do at my website, and have people go to the different places that I'm at Facebook, because some folks would rather shop on Facebook than they have at my website. Some folks would rather shop on Facebook than at Google, and rather shop on Facebook than at YouTube channels. So just know that it is a free opportunity for you to get started. Here's an example. This is my home page, and I let people know that they can click on two or three different places and find me on Facebook, and I'm encouraging you to think about doing the same thing. Now, how do you get started there? Once you have your Facebook account, and if you don't have one, I want you to do it. Some of you already do because I've seen you there, and some of you, what you do have on Facebook is so lacking in information and business coordinated that it needs a lot of attention. But on your Facebook page, here's a picture of my Facebook page during the holidays. There's a place right up here that's called Menu, and that'll be the first place that you click on Menu. And then from there, once you get to the menu, you click over here on Page. So what I'm encouraging you to do here is to start with your personal page and then go to this page here and start making business-related pages on Facebook to help people find you there and do business with you. When you get to that create a page situation, it looks like this, or it did in December. They had just changed it, but now they've even changed it again. But it's very similar to this, so we can talk about it. When you're creating a page, a business page on Facebook, you're going to need to have an idea for what the name is and the description of what you're selling there, and you'll just type in the blanks and click it away. In a minute, we're going to talk about, see this slot here for your main preview desktop image, and then also your page name. You don't have to come up with two photographs to get started there. So after you do that, it will lead you down and ask you to insert the photographs, a large one and a smaller one. So when you get ready to do this, have your two photographs ready. Here's an example of what you actually have. This is the page that I set up for business people in Kinston. Notice I got a picture of the downtown here. And then for the small photograph, we got a picture of Greg's Entrepreneur Center, the Enterprise Center on down on Main Street, to put on that page here that we've got for Kinston business folks. Here's a copy of one of my pages, CarverEquipment.com, featuring on what we're selling on the internet, different types of equipment. I've got a page for that. Then I've got a page for giving the webinars, call it 360 Management. And on and on and on, you can have as many pages as you want to put up. And I'm going to encourage you, as I'm going to start doing this week, is to start adding a different Facebook page for each one of my profit centers, because the search engines like Google will find those pages before they even find the ones at your website. Here's a page at Facebook that I did for my book sales, Journey for a Lifetime, where folks can go and actually order books right off of Facebook pages. And here's the page that we did for Kinston with Greg's photograph in it, telling all about the small business center and how to get in touch with it. You just got all the flexibility that you need. Also, if you're having a special event at your business, you're able to put a date in and encourage people to come to certain events, like a sale that you're having or a grand opening. This is a great way for you to let people in your local community know that to come to your location or that you've got something special going on. If you're a book writer, like you're going to have a book reading, if you're doing work at a certain place, let's say you got a house painting business and you're painting a certain house and you're getting ready to finish it up, you could have an event and encourage people to drive by that house on a certain day and time. All different flexibilities you need, and there's no charge for this. You can plan events right there at no charge whatsoever. Then any of the type of advertising that you're doing on Facebook, if it meets your criteria, you can spend a little bit of money and have Facebook send your ads out to different places all over the United States or right in your community. The nicest thing about it, and this is called boosting. Boosting is a type of pay for click. That is, you pay a certain amount of money if people click on your ad. So that helps ads pay for themselves. You can put $20 out there, but if only three people click on it, your bill might not be but 30 cents. So Facebook doesn't overcharge you. They only charge you when people actually click on your ads. Also, you can pick out where you want your ads to show or who your audience is, how old the folks are, and even what towns they live in or what counties. Like this particular ad I was running on the day I did this slide was focused on the area around Montgomery County, Troy, Biscoe, Candor area. So that's where I wanted these ads to go, because I was encouraging people to come to a seminar over at Montgomery Community College. So I focused on that particular area for that ad. You can select how long you want your ads to run, one day through continuously, and you can actually set the date that the ads will stop running. So here you can set your budget. This ad I was doing for $20, and once you get it set, you hit the boost button down here, and you basically spent some money. So to do this advertising online with Facebook, you're going to need to give them a credit card number that they will hold and keep in their files. Now, once you've got your ad up and running, here comes the real beauty. Once your ad's up, you can invite all your friends that you have on your personal page. And this is why it's important that you have a personal page, so you can invite all your friends, or the ones that you want to visit the ad that you've just put in on your business page. Hence, you can have as many as 5,000 friends on your personal page at Facebook. 5,000. I'm going to encourage you to try to have 5,000 friends if you want to use this for business purposes. Now, when I'm saying that you're going after a friend, I'm not talking about a buddy-buddy person that you really know or have an interest in creating a personal relationship with them. No, you're interested in creating a business contact through your friends on Facebook. And there's lots of different ways to really boost the number of those friends that you have. The simplest and fastest way to do it is for you to visit your other friends' Facebook pages, click on their friends, see who all their friends are, and then just start inviting them to be your friend as well. And many of them will, some of them won't. But as soon as you start building up your friends list, then that's going to give you more people that you can send free information to about your business. It's marketing, and it's guerrilla marketing, because it's not costing you anything to do this. It's just being smart. Now, remember that for you to see more people and for more people to buy your product, that means you have to make it easier for them to find you. And having more pages related to your Facebook account is a direct vehicle with more people being able to find you. So here's a copy of my pages that I had already created on this particular day. I'm probably going to double that or triple these number of pages in the next 2 weeks, because it's the time of year that I can have a few minutes to do that. So I'll have a different page now for sickle bar mowers, for solar farm mowing equipment, for hay balers, for tractor canopies. So this list is going to get longer and longer. Why do I want to do that? Because when someone goes to Google and types in a search term, Facebook and eBay are the most powerful generators of search engine findings in the whole system. So anytime you can post something on a Facebook business page that is specifically and easy to find with a search term, your chances of getting that customer to find you really go up. And basically it just takes you a little help. And also, you don't have to keep coming back to these. Once you do it, you can pretty much forget it. You just need to make sure that in that page information that you tell the people that land on that page how to get in touch with you, or what your website information is, or your email address, or your telephone number. So once they find you, they can go right on and do business with you. At Facebook, they're going to tell you the results of the money that you spend. They'll tell you actually how many people you reached and how much it cost you. On this particular day, if you'll notice, I had reached 97 people. And for those 97 people to open my ad, it cost me 54 cents. For whatever it was, that was my cost. As the ad progressed, it might have went up or it might have not. So over that 1 day period, I had spent $1.07 on different ads. Now, away from Facebook now for a minute, and let's talk about you. If you're just starting in business, or maybe you've been in business a while but haven't taken your business to the internet, which is our main focus today, here's what I want to suggest you to do. In your handout, you've got this slide here. It's up to you to get organized by listing down what your actual goals are. What are your goals related to this business that you're going to have and post on the internet? Generally, I don't talk about retail sales, but you might be just promoting your services. Maybe you know, do some accounting, consulting, mowing grass, running pressure washers, doing at-home administrative work for people, virtual assistant type work. Whatever type of businesses you're going to have, let's list down what your goals are. And those goals are going to be things like, maybe a primary goal is going to be for you to add new customers, because we have to do that. We lose a third of our customers every year. So one of our reasons we come to the internet is so we can add customers. Another reason is the customers that we already have, we want to retain them year after year after year. So a real great reason people get active on the internet is to retain customers. Now, with the customers we already had and the customers we're going to add, we get to a whole new way of managing that asset by building a customer base, generally of email addresses, of text numbers, cell phone numbers that we can text. But building this customer base is a critical ingredient for keeping your website and your internet sales going on and on and on and enjoying a lot of repeat business. When you get that continuous repeat business or continuous new business coming in, that equals cash flow. And positive cash flow is the heartbeat for all of our small businesses. So that is the ultimate goal, right? More continuous business and a positive cash flow, hopefully all year long. I want you to enjoy having some money coming in January, February, March, April, all the way back around to November and December. 12 months a year is easier to achieve positive cash flow by utilizing the internet than any other vehicle I know of that you can do, because so many people shop there, and that you can create your niche markets to keep them coming back. When you're doing this, you will enjoy more years of more sales with less stress. More sales and less stress is a winning combination, right? I know it is for me, and I get all the stress that I need, but what makes it a little bit easier to deal with is actually seeing some positive cash flow coming in. Now, your mindset has everything to do with the success of your website. And when your mindset is that my website is my virtual storefront, in other words, my customers that come to me by internet are just as important to me as my customers that come to me and knock on this door over here and come in here and actually have me order or talk about the equipment. Both are very important, but if you start shortchanging the importance of your internet customers versus the ones that you are seeing face-to-face or in person, then you're hurting yourself. Now, when I started internet sales 35 years ago at Carver Equipment Company, and I had employees that had been with me for 20 years that were used to having a customer walk through the front door in the showroom, sit down at the counter on the stools there, and they'd chit-chat, had that personal relationship. And they just had a hard time getting used to treating my email customers just as important as the walk-in customers. And I really had to have some stern conversations with my employees. So if you're already in business and you're here today, and there's so many of you here, I want to welcome all of you. If you're here today just figuring out how to turn your bricks and mortar business into an internet business, then let me encourage you. It's your mindset that's going to make all the difference in the world, and it's your mindset that's going to count, not someone else's. So let's think about that virtual website. So there's three kinds of websites. And maybe you're going to need one of each of all three, or maybe you'll just need one, but there's three different types. And as you're planning your business now, actually we're going to talk about doing a business plan for your website or for your internet business. Let's determine then, do you want a website that's selling products, as this one does for me at CarverEquipment.com, or do you want a website that's selling services, like this one does for me for FastForwardServices.net, where it lists all the different types of services that we provide, counseling, giving seminars, public speaking, motivational talking, those kind of things, or writing, helping people write books. This website is all about helping people with services. Or maybe you want to provide information to people, like this example that I have here at lookier.biz, providing information to folks, and on those pages selling advertisement. So you got a lot of different types of services or products that you might be offering, and it may boil down that you need three websites, or maybe just one, or maybe two. But if you have a question about that, then it's important that when you listed down all those goals, and as we talk about in a minute, all the different things on the menu that you're going to offer to sell, then we can determine if you need one or more websites. So that's the reason for having this little chat. You can have the same type of pages at Facebook as I've got here. On your Facebook pages, you can have a page at Facebook for each one of the websites that you're thinking about doing, and you can do your Facebook pages in advance, and then that'll make it easier when you get ready to do your website and actually start spending money, because at Facebook, you can put it up, take a look at it, change it around before you start your website information and save a lot of money, but still go ahead and start doing business right away. So, thanks for hanging with me so far. I know I'm throwing a lot of information at you. What I want you to do is follow your notes, try to absorb what you need to absorb now that's important to you now. And this is all about where you are at this point and what are the next two or three levels you need to get to. So as you're keeping up notes and thinking about what questions that you're going to ask me or Greg, just keep in mind that some of this stuff may apply to you now, or maybe it doesn't, but it won't hurt to listen to it all and to figure out how to help you get to the next step. So how do we start here? We start with a business plan. Just like you were doing any kind of business, whether it's internet or not, it's going to be important to you that you have a business plan. Why is that? Because a business plan will help you avoid unexpected expenses and pitfalls. And on the internet, help you avoid unexpected surprises. So this is a graphic of a business plan for every business, but it can also apply to your internet. So I'd encourage you to use your handout, print it out, and just start penciling in the different types of expenses that you're going to have, and then let's pencil in the different types of revenues that you hope to have, because the business plan that's good for you is going to tell you what's left. What's left after we subtract our expenses from our revenues, and that's what's left needs to be one of the goals that you're setting. Yeah, we'll set the goal, as you say, down at the bottom here and then work our way up. Now, I mentioned to you that Thursday night with our Academy series, 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock, we'll be focusing on business plan. So if you'd like to attend that webinar, just let me know and I'll give you the information to get there. Now, just as important as the business plan is your marketing plan. And in an internet business, it is critical. It is absolutely critical that you develop a marketing plan that produces results. So I like to call my marketing plan the golden goose plans, because not only will they tell you what's going on now, but hopefully your marketing plan is going to start telling you what you need to stock and plan to sell next week, next month, and next year. A good marketing plan is going to tell you what's next. Help you make the sale now, but more importantly, help you follow up to get information from your customer to determine what's next. Now, in our Academy series, week after next, which is actually week 3, we'll be talking all about the marketing plan, and in week 4, how to help customers find you, which will cover some of the information we're talking about today. The beauty of a website is, once you get it up and running and you develop a good customer base and start making money, websites can be sold. Even though it's an intangible thing, you can't hold a website in your hand, but you can show a track record. You can show a business plan. You can show how many people are visiting your website, what pages are good, and how much money you're making. So you're not wasting your time by thinking about creating an internet sales business, because in today's world, it's one of the easiest businesses to sell and one that you can get some real bucks for, depending on how well that you plan it and how well that you manage it. So that's a good thing. I can't say that about all businesses, but a good website that's making money is a website that you can sell fairly easily. 12 steps now to online marketing. Number one, let's choose the type of business that you want to go. Several options, and you may choose one or all of them. An affiliate business, an example of that would be, you want to have an online sales business, but you want to do it through someone else's website. So if you are selling items on eBay, you've got an online internet business. You're using eBay's platform to sell your business products. Or it may be Etsy, or it may be Craigslist, or it could be Amazon.com. Those are affiliated businesses where you're not going to the expense to have your own website. You're just selling your products through e-commerce than someone else's site. Now, you may want to have informational websites, like I showed you at lookyear.biz, where you're providing information through someone else's website and selling your skills or the information that you're doing. Then maybe you're going to sell your own products and services with other options, and such as that, where that you have your actually website, and there's several different types that you can have. And maybe you're already a reseller or a retailer, a wholesaler, and you just now want to take that business from your brick and mortar store or your mobile business you've got doing and start promoting that business on the internet. So first of all, answer this question for yourself, and there are questions that I would need to ask you when we talk. Now, let's research the market. Yeah, use Google search terms and determine what other people are doing in the markets that you're thinking about serving. Find the niche market areas that are not oversaturated with online businesses. Find the ways that you can apply your products and services to particular niche markets and maybe have a greater office that's going to be following you. We don't probably need to create a legal entity, because when you go out on the internet, you expose yourself to a lot of issues. And if any of those issues might find you in court for someone suing you for one reason or another, it's going to be really good that you have some type of corporate entity. And 99% of the customers, maybe it's 99.9 during the last 4 years, we'll be going with what we call the LLC. That's the Limited Liability Corporation. Very easy to get it done, and also very inexpensive. But that's something that you will want to be talking about as you're doing your planning. Right now, today, if you're just getting started, not necessary. But very soon, once you start making sales on the internet, you're probably going to want to become an LLC or some other type of corporation. Now, it's time to create a presence. If you're one of those that have just thinking about it and ready to get started now, then it's time to do it. Let's quit procrastinating. And you can do that with one of these other sites that I've mentioned. You can create your own website. You can create your own YouTube channel. Yeah, a YouTube channel is just like having a website of videos. And very powerful, maybe the most powerful thing going on new today is that you Google My Business. It offers the same type of opportunity to get out there and get started. So my question to you right now, and if you might just answer this in chat, just to let me know, do you already have a website presence? Do you already have an internet presence in any way? And if you do, let me know what it is. Let me know what you're doing now. And you might mention that, what do you want to do next? And when you tell me what you want to do next, that'll help me determine if I have a study guide or a tip that I can send to you, or know that we're going to have a webinar soon that might answer that question for you. Number five, time to get that website. So think about your domain. We don't say the name of my website is so-and-so. We say the domain name of my website is so-and-so. So when you hear that word domain, it's talking about the name of a website. And I want to encourage you now that these domain names are very important. Choosing a name that helps customers find you or helps customers find the product you're selling is really important to the success of your website. So let's keep that in mind. And if you want to send me options that you're thinking about, I'll be glad to give you feedback on them. And I've got a handout that I can send to you that talks about naming your domain, naming your company, and naming your DBA. So when you're registering your domain, that's important. Now, you're not going to own the name of your website. You're not. You kind of rent it for 3 to 5 years. A government corporation manages all the domain names. So basically you pay a fee for a certain period of time, and you basically have to bid on it. And when you come up with a name, it may have a price tag of $5 a year or $5,000 a year, depending on how many people are requesting that name. So keep that in mind. They use that money to help manage the World Wide Web and the Internet. A host for your website. Well, if you're going with an affiliate, someone else is doing the hosting. You don't have to worry about it. But if you don't have your own website, then you're going to need to find a host. Now, normally a host is a company that has a lot of servers. And a server is a small electronic device about the size of your VCR at home. Okay? And a large nationwide host might have a huge brick building that's got a million servers in it just whirling and making noise and generating heat. Each one of those servers is running the software for different websites inside of it. That's right. It just runs all the time. So the host is managing equipment that sends your message as you and your webmaster have put into your website. The host has that device there called a server that takes that message that you've got available to the world and pumps it into the pipeline of the World Wide Web. In other words, they take your information and put it into the pipeline. Your little pipeline, your little tube, goes from your email address to your host, and the host takes in what you send to them and then pumps it out to the world, and it's an important job to do. Every website has a host. I don't even know who my host is because my webmaster looks after that. That's why it's good to have a webmaster. Now, we need to have your website designed. That is, what is the content in it? What are the pictures? What are the landing pages? How does it look? How easy is it to negotiate? So lots of people will host and design your websites. There are a lot of companies that do this for you, and they say they're doing it free. GoDaddy.com and some others are good examples. They'll invite you to come and do business with them, and they'll help you get your website up and running for free. Well, here's the fact of the matter. You don't own that website. You don't own it. You don't manage it. You can't take it up or down. Someone else owns that. Yeah, they're doing it for you for free, but here's the deal. Once that website starts making some money, once you start getting a lot of traffic on it, then you're going to start getting some bills from them. You're going to get some requests for payments. So just remember, there's no free lunch on the Internet, just like there's not really any free lunch anywhere else. Eventually, we're going to have to ante up and pay the price. Now, you can design your website yourself, maybe. I don't know how much skill you have. I can tell you that whatever skills that you developed 10 years ago are probably old today and will not give you the best website that you can have. Website design is an ever-evolving and changing situation. So just know that if you want to spend a lot of your time tinkering with your website versus spending a lot of your time selling to your customers, that's your choice to make. Now, I'm 74 years old, and I'll tell you that I don't want to spend my time tinkering with the mechanics of every web page. That's why I hire and keep and have had the same guy for 35 years now that looks after my website. He makes all the changes. He sends me a reasonable bill, and I pay him, and I spend as much time as I can serving my customers. Now, the rest of the story is after the COVID came and all the everybody started changing their prices and increases, the webmaster can't do it all for you. So when it comes to making changes, there will be seasons. Excuse me. Just like we have now, that you'll have to make time to send your webmaster changes that have to be made, and he'll do it for you and send you a bill. One of the handouts that you got today are the SEO, Search Engine Optimization. That's the initials there. It is a very important handout. I want you to read every word of it. And after you finish reading every word, I want you to read it again. Because what helps people find your website versus all the billions or millions of other websites that are out here on the World Wide Web is SEO. Search engine optimization helps a customer find you, the needle in the haystack or the needle in the needle stack, helps them find you versus everybody else. And it's the way that we go about managing our words and our text and our content and our videos on our web pages. You can put a lot of information on a web page, but if it's not in line with your best SEO priorities, then nobody's ever going to see that web page, and you're never going to make any money on it. So SEO is really important. You need to own an understanding of how it works. Pay-per-click, SEO, blogging and newsletters, sending comments to people at other websites, advertising your website in every time you have a chance. That's the way you promote your tool. That's the way you promote your website. The website is just going to sit there by itself, and it's not going to automatically have people come to you. You have to initiate and create and motivate and promote in a lot of different ways to have people end up at your website pages. It's up to you to do that. Your webmaster can help you do it, and if he's not helping you do it, then he needs to be fired or she needs to be fired and get one that will, because accountability is very important. If you're brand new in this, I'm going to tell you, as I'm doing right now, what the important tools are to promote your website. But if you're hiring a professional webmaster, they should have a lot of this information on their own and build it into the plan. I mean, after all, that's what you're really paying for. A critical component of promoting your website is your ability to have lots of email contact where you can send an email to a customer. And in that email, presents them the bait to get interested in something that you're selling. And the tool will be the email link to a page at your website so that when you get the email, they can click on a link inside that email and go to a web page, a landing page, where you're going to sell them some product. That's how the system works. Now, you will notice that when I get your email addresses, that I'll send you email and usually give you a link or some information there. So the collection of email contact information is absolutely critical to the success and growth and sustainability of not only your website, but mainly of your business as a whole. So let's think to ourselves now. Who are the customers that I want to target? Who are the particular customers, the niche market folks, that I want to spend my time on trying to get to come to my website, because this is where I have profit centers that will be attractive to them? So one of the 30 Street Smart drill skills that you've got a copy of is we can't be all things to all people. We can't be everything to everybody, right? But in our business, just like with our websites, we must be everything to some people. We must be everything to some people. And those some people, those fortunate few, will become your raving fan customers. So let's start thinking now who your most likely best customers will be. Males, females, what age groups are they? What's their heritage? What are they most interested in? With that information, you'll create a website that is very attractive to them to begin with. That way you'll help jumpstart your business. That way you'll know how to do your best Google searches and put content on those pages that will help you get their business. Just like I mentioned, I know that a lot of my customers buying farm equipment are veterans, so I let them know that I'm a veteran. I know that a lot of my customers buying equipment from me nationwide are Christians, so I let them know that I'm a good member of the Methodist Church. And every now and then I'll let them know that I believe in Jesus Christ, my Savior, and I think it's good for us to pray and to say God bless you to people to help people along. When you let people know, when you know what type of person you are, and you can relate to certain types of folks better than others, then we'll feed that information into the content of your web pages, and that'll help people start creating a relationship with you with meaning that will last year after year, hence you'll have repeat business. We're going to use the social media every time we can to not only sell our products, but to send people to our web pages every time. And my suggestion here to you now is there's so many different types of social media that you select one and master it. Select one and master it. Actually, I want to say today, for the first time in a new year, I want you to select two of them and master them. The number one, I want you to master how to manipulate to help your business is Facebook, as I've already said earlier. But the number two is YouTube. I want you to have that YouTube channel of your own because it is a website in itself to help you promote your businesses, not with just content, not with text, and not with photographs, but with video messaging. So I want to encourage each of you to start doing your YouTube videos, and let's get them on the internet to help folks relate to you easier. We'll talk a lot about this on Thursday night as well. Let's build a customer base. Start today thinking about creating a list of email addresses, as many as you can create, just like I want you to have as many Facebook friends as you can possibly have. I want you to have a database with as many email addresses as you can put together, and you'll use those email addresses to encourage people to visit your web pages or your Facebook pages. Now, one of the questions that puzzles and causes people some problems when they're getting started with an internet business is, how are people going to pay me? Well, you're used to going to Amazon and just clicking a button and it's paid for on your credit card, right? And so many websites have shopping carts, so people can shop and click there and send you your money. Maybe it's PayPal that they use, like on eBay. Or accept payments online, where just you can just type in your credit card information and people will send you their money by their credit card. All those are ways to collect money, but I want to tell you it's not necessary. If you're just getting started, there's nothing at all wrong with people doing business with you by calling you up or sending you an email and asking you how much it is, and you tell them it's this amount if you're paying with a check or cash, or it's this amount if you're paying with a credit card. 35 years later, that's the way I do it today. I do not want shopping carts at CarverEquipment.com. I don't want people using PayPal. I don't want people using Google Checkout for several reasons. Number one reason is when someone is able to buy your product or send you an order without ever having a communication with you as an individual, that cuts you out from creating a personal relationship with them. That's right. That cuts you out from the best chance of having a continuing relationship that you can stay in touch with them and send them more information on a personal matter. Number two, every time that you add a function to your website that lets someone else do a service for you, there's going to be a cost involved there. Like PayPal, normally 7%. Your shopping carts are usually a minimum of 3%. Other types of online payments are 3-6%. And then when you add the credit card fees on top of that, you may be giving 15% of your profit away just with services that you could have handled yourself very easily, plus kept a relationship with your customer. So give me just a minute. We got some background noise coming in. Let me see if I ask you to mute your mics, if you will, everyone but Greg. And maybe we can find out where it's at. Just one second. Okay, I think it's handled now. Thank you. Again, it's okay for you to do business on the internet and accept payments directly from customers. You do not have to have the shopping carts, the Google Checkout, the PayPal, and the online payments. If you absolutely want it and don't want a website without it, you don't want the personal relationship, then that's the way to get it. But there is a fee involved. And to begin with, I want to encourage you, don't go there until you're ready actually to start doing some business. Learn the ropes doing it one-on-one, and then maybe try some other ways. Number 10, once you get an order, how's that customer going to receive the products that you've sold? Well, maybe you're just going to download with them, give them a product they can download, like a book or certain information. Or maybe you want UPS or FedEx or United or the post office to mail it to them. But that means that you've actually got to go there and do that and do the packaging and the wrapping and the labels and put the filler in and such as that. That's what I do. I do small shipping myself, but my large items, I have them shipped directly from a warehouse. So getting the product to the customer is called the order fulfillment. How's that going to happen? So you need to be given some thought. Is this something that you can manage easily, or are you going to need to hire some folks to help you or figure out a way to get it done? If you don't have answers to that, but you know what you're going to be selling, just drop me an email or put it in chat, and I'll try to give you some information related to help you figure out the fulfillment aspects of your website. Number 11 is credibility. And credibility is super, super important, because if you're not honest and legitimate, you're not going to make it. The website, if it does a lot of things bad, but one thing it does good, let me tell you, you screw up and a million people are going to know about it in 5 minutes. Social media and chat rooms and such as that, if you're not shooting straight with your customers, it's going to end up on the World Wide Web before you can blink your eyes. That's one side of it. But a really good side of it is, if you are honest and you are legitimate and you do work really hard to give 100% customer satisfaction, the other side will work too, because people will spread that news as well. Sometimes we have to encourage them to do it, to spread it better through testimonials and such as that. But just know that establishing your credibility is really important. Why? The biggest reason people will not do business with you on the internet is they don't trust you. Not because they think you're bad. It's just because you haven't earned their trust. So someone just getting started on the internet with sales, you got to get past that credibility issue and being honest to begin with, and helping people prove to themselves that you're a good Joe goes a long, long way. And we can talk about lots and lots of ways to do that. I like to say there's just as much customer service, and there's just as much importance for the incredible power of hospitality on the internet through your internet sales as there is in a face-to-face situation with your customer coming into a bricks and mortar store. How can you prove credibility? The most easiest and inexpensive way is to have testimonials from your customers. Create and get your customers to give you testimonials and references, because when those pages are at your website, you are creating credibility. And it just puts you ahead of everyone else that hasn't done it. And so many people have not done it. Now, as someone new coming on, and a lot of you folks that are with me this afternoon will be brand new, you haven't established any credibility at all probably at this point. And I want to say to you, that is one of the primary priorities for you to give some thought to. And I'll be glad to send to you some samples of how to create testimonials from customers and a number of other things, show you different types of videos. Let me know if you'd like to have those, and I'll be glad to send them to you free at no charge. Now, hospitality is a power that you can transmit at your website and through your emails just as easily as you can looking someone face to face, eyeball to eyeball. It's the terms that you use and the way that you say things and having those videos there, welcoming videos, can just go a long way that keeps your web page from being just something on somebody's computer screen to a megaphone for you to show them who you are and tell them in real terms and smile and show them your beautiful face, or in my case, not beautiful at all, but at least show them I'm a human being that's here trying to make a living as a salesman. And I need to, and I can say things like, hey, I need your money. I got 14 grandkids and they all need new shoes. You know, I'm a human being just like you, so let's do some business. Just a cold, hard web page can't send that message out and can't create that smile on someone's face. So let me ask you now, as after today, and you're looking at different web pages, as we all do all the time now, think about those web pages that you click on and you hear something or you see something that makes you smile or makes you feel good. Very few, right? Most of them are just so full of hard, cold information and selling. But when you create and insert hospitality into your web pages and into your videos and into your emails, then you are a step above everybody else in the game. I mean, you have set your standards higher, and therefore people will recognize that and want to do more business with you. On the internet, getting rid of all those anxieties, one of the most powerful tools that you can use is to share with the world what you're proud of in yourself. To share with the world what you would like to have common denominators with other people. Maybe it's the church affiliation, that you're a teacher, that you're a veteran. Maybe you're interested in scouting. Maybe you're from Jamaica. Right, and you're really into being from Jamaica this week because of the Jamaican bobsled team, right? I mean, that bobsled team and going to China from the tropical country always creates a lot of goodwill. Maybe the different sports that you're interested in, the hobbies, the neighborhoods you live in, or other family connections, different civic clubs that you belong to and feel good about what you're doing there. Like I'm a Mason and a Shriner, I'm a Coast Guard veteran, member of the American Legion, Methodist Church, member of the Dunn Area Chamber of Commerce. Anyone that's any of those things might feel better about doing business with me because they know that we have common denominators. Fill your website up with opportunities that you can do it. And the way I do it is this bar that you see right here, that's just one image that I create, and I put that at the bottom of every one of my emails going out, as well as I have it on my homepage at our website. So you can use the images to send the message if you want to. And of course, here's one of the most important ones that people report to me is these cancer ribbons, because my wife and I both right now are cancer survivors, and the world is full of us. And people know that if you've been a member of this club, you've been through some stuff that you've got common denominators with them, and they will mention that, and they will want to chat about it and say thank you for promoting, you know, research to stop cancer. Anytime that you're doing that, it helps people feel better about doing business with you. So let's go back to those ultimate goals now. We want to add new customers. We want to retain the customers we already have. We want to build our customer base. We're going to do all these things so we can have a continuous flow of cash, so we can have more cash coming in than money that goes out. And we want to do this for year after year after year with more sales and less stress. And when we're ready to hang it up, or someone makes us an offer we can't refuse, we want to be ready to sell this internet business and put some real money in the bank. Now, I want your internet site to be so successful that it brings you a great big $1 million price. So one day you'll call me up and say, hey, Steve-O, I'm down here at Key Largo. let me fly you down here, and let's sit here and celebrate the good news you gave me and the good business I had." It is just that opportunity is there. You hear about it every day, about someone creating that website, and they did it just right. Bought in lots and lots of customers with great new ideas, and you can have those ideas. Yeah, the beauty about the internet is that it's a common playing field for all of us, provided that you play by the rules and mainly the foundations that I'm talking about here today. So let's start helping shoppers find your particular web pages, because that's the key. I mean, if someone turns their computer on and goes to Google, the whole world is at their disposal, but you want them to find your needle in the needle stack. So how do you do that? All right, so pay attention now. First of all, include your domain name, or within your domain name, include that information in everything that you do print. Your business card, your other ads, excuse me, come here. Newspaper, magazine, email you're sending out, your envelopes that you send out. Let me show you something right here. See here? See my envelope? I don't know if you can see it good in the light or not. But on my envelope, I actually got the title on my envelope is CarverEquipment.com. So when I send out checks or invoices or letters to people, when they're holding that in their hand, they're seeing CarverEquipment.com. Then they see Steve Carver and the name of my business for Fast Forward Services. And so promoting your website first and foremost is the best way you can to get people to find you. And then really put to work the SEO practices that's talked about in the handout that I give to you, how to put the search terms on your web pages so people will find you. Next, using outside guerrilla marketing tools to help folks find you, like through Google and Maps and calendars and Google My Business. And then most people that are specifically shopping for you, it's important that you have your mobile pages set up that when folks type in those search terms, they'll end up at your mobile page. And if they do, you were smart enough to have those call me now, text me now, get in touch with me now, so that what you're doing is creating a way to create that communication link with your customer. So using print ads to promote your website, doing all you can with your SEO practices, using the guerrilla marketing tools, Google My Business, eBay, Amazon.com, and your mobile pages to bring people to you. So it's action time. If you're interested in getting started now, here's what we need to do. Action time. Number one, start searching the web using the search terms that you would think your customers would use trying to find you if you had a website. And then what I want you to do is to find the top three websites where you find the people that are doing what you want to do like you want to do it. Find websites that are easy to navigate, that make you feel good, that you think will make your customers feel good about shopping there. And then what I want you to do is save the links, save the domain names, just set up a file, and save those links to those different websites. Then you're going to be able to say to your potential webmaster, if you're hiring somebody to help you, or if you're going to do it yourself, you will basically copy the pages, copy the style, copy the navigation tools that someone is already using so that you don't have to reinvent the wheel. You just copy those pages in your software, pull out their photographs, pull out their context and your narrative content, and insert your information. that'll save you from having to reinvent the wheel and hours of work. Excuse my phone over there. I just had to ring a minute. And help you get your website up and running in such a way that it doesn't cost you a ton of time plus a ton of money. Okay? Next, get your business location. Know what the driving address is, your GPS address, and your mail to address, your post office box, your phone number, any information related to texts and messaging to, and your hours of operation. Write all that down in a nice form. Now, you will need all this for your Google My Business account, so you're not wasting your time, but your webmaster is going to need it as well. Now, let's list down all the products and services that you're going to be offering. In other words, you're going to create a list or a menu of everything that's going to be a profit center for you. Now, a marketable profit center is something that's generating business for you, a product or service. Marketable means that you can market it separately from other things. And that's really important because when we list down our marketable profit centers, we're in mind are going to have web pages and different sections in our website for each one of those products. That's right. In other words, we're just not going to have one web page that's got the menu on it, but we're going to have a web page that has a menu and then a place that you can click on those different items and go to your landing pages where people can buy that particular product. Okay? Now, let's see. We've got some other interference coming in. Let's see if we can find it. There it is. Okay, that's like Vanessa, want to welcome you on board. Glad to have you on board today. Now, let's list down the different types of products. Now, let's name those different product centers that we just mentioned with some narrative, some brief conversation about telling about this particular product and what it will do for people. What's the advantage for them having it? And then we're going to create images. We're going to find photos and diagrams and technical information that will have to do with each one of your profit centers. In other words, we're getting ready to tell our story, telling the story about these different profit centers. There's Carl, glad to have you on board. Just muted your mic. This imaging that you're doing is really important to save you money. When you're doing these seven things we've talked about, you've cut the cost from creating a website from, let's say it was going to be $2,000 to begin with, that the webmaster was doing it all, or in other words, he or she was just going to talk to you a few minutes, and then you tell them what all you wanted them to do, and then they go do it. Let's say that was going to cost you $2,000, $2,500. But if you're taking these seven steps so that when you contact your webmaster and you're saying, here's what I want, here's the content, here's the pages I want you to copy, here's my business information, and here's the photos and images and diagrams I want you to use, you cut that $2,500 cost down to probably $1,000. Yeah, big time difference, or even more sometime. So instead of you spending 3 or 4 months building this website, you spend 2 days getting this information together, let them build your website, and you start selling, making money to help pay for it. That's called website creation action time. So your business images are important. Here's some of the ones that I use. Now, I'll mention up here at the top of my homepage, see this picture of this freight truck here? That image is part of a slideshow. At our website, every 6 or 7 seconds, that slide will change and there'll be a different message up there. So that no matter what page at our website that you're on, you're going to see these messages changing, which in each message is going to be informational or about another profit center that lets you know that I've got this and I've got this and I've got that so that we can do upselling. Having your website to be able to do upselling for you is really, really important. So as we say here on this slide, think about what the face of your website is going to be. What's that home page going to look like? How about flags or artwork or taglines, slogans, mission statements and vision statements? Tell it about your history or your lineage of your country, company. I like to talk about our history of our company here that you see right here at the cursor. Also, when folks send in testimonials about the training we're doing, like on today, I might have your testimonial listed here where it can be read. Retail customers that buy things, I got testimonials there. References that professionals have given to me. I talk about our fast forward services work we do. And for folks, I sell some pretty expensive stuff, and people might be trying to figure out how much per month it's going to cost them. A payment calculator they can click on. This is a Google map that shows people actually where our distribution center is, and it don't cost very much money, but it's kind of a critical ingredient. And then here's an important place that, remember how important it is to create your database. If you have a place on your Facebook, on your web pages that people can subscribe, that is to give you their email addresses, then you can add them to your database and then start sending them out custom promotions. Just all these are different tools to help you promote your website. So let's go ahead and get that domain name for your website. And the easiest way to do that, there can't be but one domain name forever for just one in the whole world. And GoDaddy offers us a service at this website, at this web page, where you can go and type in the domain name you're thinking about naming your website, and it'll tell you whether it's already taken or not, whether it's available, and how much it'll cost you for 1 year or 5 years. And if you get what you want, you might want to reserve it. Excuse me. GoDaddy.com. Now, the rest of the story is, when I first got started, everybody wanted your website name to end in .com. That day has passed. .biz, .net, .org, .everything it seems like in the world you can think about, .usa, and .gov. There's plenty of those out there. So now it's easier to get a domain name with the actual names that you want than it used to be. You might have to make a few changes and other considerations. Now, if your domain name is one and your business is one that you want to protect from other people of stealing your website, and a lot of people will do that, if you've got something that's really hot and really cool and you named it CarverEquipment.com, then I don't want other people to get CarverEquipment.net and try to steal my business from me. So I might reserve .com, .net, .biz to keep to give you some security there, and that'll cost you a little bit of money more each year, but it's a way of protecting your name. So this is the GoDaddy.com place that you can go to check out your domain names. So let's talk about the webmaster. Who is the webmaster? That's an individual that you can hire to get your website set up, to find the host for you, to design your web pages, to do the maintenance for you, to pay the bills for you each year, and just kind of to look after and manage your website. Now, it'll be your responsibility to send them the changes that have to be made, or they'll set up ways that you can make some changes yourself. However, you do want to do your homework. I want you to check out their work, this webmaster you're thinking about hiring. I want you to see their own website promotions and references, and talk with other businesses that are using them. Now, if you want to hire someone to help you get your website up and running, give you a quotation on doing this, then I'll be glad to share with you several names of people that I know have done good work for other clients, and you can contact them and get quotes from them if you'd like. And I'll be glad to share. I have three or four different references that I can send to you people to contact to give you quotes on building your website. I can tell you that if you just want a basic startup thing, two or three years ago, it was $650. Now it's for like more like $950 for just a basic buy your domain and get your server and your host and do the basic design. If you have sent this information to me, you can expect to spend $700 to $900. The more extensive and bigger that you make it, you're going to start paying for time, and that will determine on how large you want to make it. The average website costs at I've seen entrepreneurs get started and paid a professional webmaster to do it during the last 3 years has run between $900 and $3,000 on average. Others, for more money, it was people that already had established businesses. So I'll be glad to help you with that and help you move forward as much as you'd like to. Let me go back and say, though, Google My Business, Facebook, and your YouTube channels, zero cost. Zero cost. And those are ways you can get started selling tomorrow without spending big bucks on internet fees. But these are also things that you're going to want to have in place, if you can, when you actually get your own website up and running, because you'll use those places to send businesses to your website where you'll have a better opportunity to grow your business and maintain your customer base better. So when you're contacting your webmaster, introduce yourself. Make sure that this is someone, a man or woman, that you can talk to without any communication problems. If you don't create a long-term relationship with a webmaster, you don't want to be able to talk with them and understand what they're saying. I prefer to do business with people locally, but that's not necessary. I know that because I started doing business with a fellow who lived in Fuquay Varina near Raleigh 30 years ago, and now he lives in Texas, and we get along just fine, but still we know how to talk to each other. They're going to need to know your goals so they can help you achieve them. And then you're going to suggest other websites, as I mentioned earlier, that you like, and you're going to encourage them to go look at them and see how they can copy what you already like and save you money. You want them to include your doing the work for your mobile page, put in show banners, Google locator maps. They can help you actually set up your Google My Business account as well. And in the webmaster world, they know how to do press releases over the internet so that people in different towns, just because you're mentioning that you're serving a certain town, a certain press release, show up all over those particular areas or in newspaper in those areas that will talk about the things that you're doing at your website. That usually costs about $75, but it's really effective for lots of different types of introduction type of situations with businesses. I want your webmaster to send you a written quotation before you send them any money. There's no reason that you have to pay someone to give you a quotation. It's very reasonable for you just to ask them. Once you send them that information I just listed, then they should be able to send you a quotation and give you at least a range that this website will cost you between this and this, depending on how far you want to go with it. And I do suggest that you get three quotations from different folks. And again, if you want some references, I'll be glad to do it. Now, notice that I'm talking about references on this, and it brings forward the, and also can have references for people to help you with your videos. Part of what we do here at the Small Business Center is a lot of networking. So as I get y'all's email addresses and you tell me what types of businesses you're in or asking questions, then we're able to network with you and other people that have already come through this process. During the last 12 years that I've been doing this, probably have created as 5,000 contacts or more, and from all different types of businesses. So I can make references about your business to someone. Or if you need some information, maybe I know someone that I can reference you. Not trying to do any favoritism here at all, but if you become active in our academy and with your small business centers, you'll get a lot of help through the networking opportunities there, because we know other folks that can help you as well. So let's kind of bring this in for a landing a little bit and talk about some things. Accountability. Hold yourself and your webmaster accountable. Sorry for this cough. It just kind of came on after we got started. Accountability is important, especially if you're paying a webmaster to do work for you. You're not having a website just so you can say, well, Steve asked me to have one and I got one. No, that's not where I'm coming from. I want this website to be a money-making tool for you. And for it to create revenue for you, you need to have what I call landing pages. That is, we're going to direct customers to come to a certain page. And on that page, you're going to use every tip and trick and ploy that you know to get them to press a button and call you up for a quotation or to actually send you an order. So it might be as simple as having a little click right here to order now, where you're suggesting that they go ahead and order now for all the different reasons that you might want to. You give them different options of how they can pay you. Like on this particular deal, they can pay me between $5,900 and $4,500. So there's lots of ways here that people can buy from you. But they still are buying direct. They're not doing this through a shopping cart. Anytime that you're going to hope to have a sale, if your message is take it or leave it. In other words, this is the price, it's take it or leave it. Then I don't tell you that a lot of people are going to leave it and keep on shopping. And that's for the reason here that I've got my price they can buy now. And I already tell them it was $5,910, but I've already discounted it to $4,499. So that is taking away that take it or leave it type thing. And the message is here, I've already discounted it for you. Let's go ahead and order it while it is discounted. But then they can also have the option to pay for it different ways. Like maybe they say, well, I don't have the cash to pay for it. When, how else I can afford to buy it? In other words, what can I do to own this piece of equipment if I don't have the cash in the bank? Well, then I let them know they can do different ways of buying over here. Even I offered it to them on eBay if there's some reason they might want to buy it through eBay. Not really, they would. I really just do that to show them that it's a lot less expensive to buy it direct than it is to pay the eBay price for it. So using those types of guerrilla marketing strategies help draw customers to you, help encourages them to go ahead and press the button and place the order. And your webmaster should know the tricks of the trade. I'm not a dull pencil, but I'm not the sharpest pencil in the world. But I expect a webmaster I pay money to know the game well enough to help me make money. And if you're not finding that with the people you're talking to about developing your website, then you keep shopping. I also mentioned this to you that as brand new entrepreneurs who may know how to do a web page through the web-based software, that software don't give you these tips about how to sell. They just tell you how to create images and include content. That's the basics. In A through Z, that's A and B. And if you're going to sell on the internet, you need to be on up there with X, Y, and Z, right? So that's what these tips are all about, and I'll be glad to share as many as I know how to do for you. Four tips to remember and own, as we talked about earlier. Remember to tell your story, to be personal in some way on every web page. And the best way to do that is up in the headers, or the top and the bottom headers, which are the same on all web pages. Have some personal information in common denominators. Focus on sending customers entering your website to the actual landing page where they buy. Don't be worried so much about sending them to your home page. Try, if you can, to send them directly to the landing page. That way, when they land there, they don't have to start searching and looking, but they land on the actual page that they searched for in the SEO. Yeah, so important. Used to be customers were just very happy to go to a new website and surf around and see what everybody had to say about them and this and that. Well, they still do that when they're getting ready to spend big money. But the first time they come to your website, they came there because of what they typed in a search term at Google or Safari. And when they land at your website, let's make sure they're on the actual page where they can buy that product. That's what your webmaster is going to help you determine, how to get them to that particular page. Constantly remember how important it is to have those mobile pages that are telling what you need to show and what folks need to find when they get to your web page. Your mobile page is what folks see on the telephone when they type in a search term. And a lot of you may not know, and most people out here in the real world do not know, that the image they're seeing on their telephone is actually one of your web pages. That's right, and it doesn't happen unless you make it happen. The importance of a mobile page is when someone types in your search terms and then it comes up on their phone, it's not a great big home page that you have to pinch and do this and do that and have a hard time getting on a certain item. That's why your mobile page needs to be really user-friendly, and it's a big deal because in America, 85 to 90% of the people that are shopping for products on the internet are doing it with their telephone, with their smartphone cell. So your mobile page is the most important page at your website. And what's the second most important page? The landing pages. Lastly, the fourth tip here is hold yourself and hold your webmaster, and I misspelled webmaster here, I need to fix that, accountable to achieve the positive results that you want and the sales that you need to stay in business. Having an internet selling platform can be one of the most rewarding things that you can possibly do in business. Why? Because I remember for years and years when my mom and dad, when I was a little boy, used to go up to Fayetteville downtown on Saturday mornings. Dad would be taking mom up there to go to a white sale at one of the department stores. You know, that opened up early to have a special sale, kind of like Black Friday sales. Well, what I remember that my daddy saying was, we'd sit out there on the street and see all these people lined up wanting to go into a store. And he was in the farm equipment business, and he said, Lord have mercy, I sure wish I had a business that people would line up to before I even got to work every morning to come and buy something from me. You know, that just don't happen at a farm equipment dealership. But it did happen at those department stores, and my dad was saying this would be something special if one day I could have a business where people did that. Well, let's fast forward now about 60 years. And you can have a business. Yes, you can have a business that when you wake up in the morning and turn your computer on and start checking your email, that people will have sent you email during the night and want you to give them a quote or sell them something. The reality of it is you can have a business that people will wait in line to give you their money, and that business is your website. That business is your ability to create customers that want to buy things from you by sending you email or forms through your website. It is incredible. And even right here in Dunn, North Carolina, a little town of 10,000 people, I can serve people all over the nation in every state, and I do it every day. Every week I'll have sales on the West Coast and in the northeast corner of the state. Today I talked with a gentleman in Florida. I got a sale from someone in Missouri. So, you know, you can do it too. Just need to find the right product mix, know who your customers are likely to be, find those folks that you can buy things from and wholesale them, find those people that you can use their hobbies and help them promote their hobbies or your own. It is a fabulous opportunity. And in 2022, after 2 years of COVID, let me tell you, in 2022, after 2 years of COVID, there's more people shopping on the internet today than has ever been there before. There's more people looking for information on the internet today than has ever been there before, just like you're here with me today. We've got people from all over the country right here learning about how to get their website up and running. The same facts and properties that we're talking about here can work for you if you go ahead and make the moves to get your website up and running. I'm not going to make a single penny whether you do or not, but I am going to say, hold yourself accountable. Don't waste any money at all. Go through the basic fundamental steps time by time. Use this handout to help you get started, but you got to do some more. This is telling you how to present your items on the internet, but when that customer comes to you, then you need to know how to sell. You need to know how to negotiate, how to forecast, how to have a business plan, how to have a marketing plan. There's a lot more than to having an internet business than just having a website. And that is an important message here, and that's where your small business centers and my Academy of Entrepreneurs and Associates can help you learn the business of running a business. You can do the internet, and you can manage a particular product that you're selling, but running the business is a whole other skill set that'll make a difference in whether you can be sustainable or not and profitable. And that's what we want you to do. So to each and every one of you, I want to say thank you. It's been a pleasure to be here and to work with you and for you. God bless you and your families, and I'll be online here a few minutes, and we'll chat. I'll try to answer any questions that you have. So be thinking about that. Use that chat button now to make sure that you're telling me your name, your email address, your hometown, the type of business that you're in, any information that you would like for me to send to you. If you'd like to know more about the Academy and other webinars you can be joining and or at Greg's operation as well, just ask those questions. We'll get them to you. And you want to know how to set up any type of other special events with me, I'll be glad to talk to you about that as well. So thank you for being with us and for doing what you're doing. We certainly do appreciate you. Let me turn off the recording and we will.